Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Around the same time, or a little earlier, to when Imam al-Ash'ari rahimahullah was busy confronting the Mu'tazila and those deviated groups in Baghdad. In the eastern part of the Islamic Empire, in a town called Maturid in Samarkand in Khurasan, which is present-day Uzbekistan, another scholar was born whom Allah had guided and aided in confronting those same Mu'tazila and other deviant groups in his part of the world. That person was Imam Muhammad ibn Mahmud al-Maturidi al-Ansari rahimahullah, who is better known to the world as Imam Abu Mansur al-Maturidi rahimahullah. Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah was one of the Hanafi ulama who shone and excelled in the deen from a very young age. It is said that the title of Al-Ansari, which is in his name, it comes from Hazrat Abu Ayyub Al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu, because some of the offspring of Hazrat Abu Ayyub radiyallahu anhu and other families from Medina had settled in Samarkand, and it is from that noble lineage of Hazrat Abu Ayyub Al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu that the great scholar, Shaykhul Islam, Imamul Huda, Imam Al-Maturidi rahimahullah was born. From young days, Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah began his study of the deen, and he studied under many of the great ulama of his time, the ulama of the land known as Mawara al-Nahr, that the land beyond the river, which was the area of Samarkand and its surrounds. Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah is one of the hidden gems of this ummah. I use the term hidden in the context of today's world where many people don't know these ulama, but back in the day, he was one of the shining stars of the Muslim world. The ulama of the time lauded him with various titles of praise for the sterling work that he had done for the deen. One of the titles that they gave him, or at least would refer to him as, was Musahihu Aqaid al-Muslimin, which means the one who rectified the aqidah of the Muslims, the very belief system of the Muslims. They gave him this title because at that time, the influence of the misguided groups had spread around the Muslim world, from east to west, and there were not many detailed explanations given of the aqidah of the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah that the normal man could turn to and rely on. So you had one deviant group saying that Qadr, predestination, doesn't exist, and another group saying that humans have no free will, a third group saying that Allah follows the will of the people, a fourth group saying that Allah has a body, and much more corruption of this nature, not to forget the Shia Rawafid and their likes as well. So Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah, he began to combat all of these groups, debating, writing books, explaining the beliefs of Islam, refuting and exposing the corrupt groups and so on. And what made him so effective is the fact that one of his main teachers was Imam Abu Bakr al-Jawzajani rahimahullah, who was the student of both Imam Abu Yusuf as well as Imam Muhammad ibn al-Hasan al-Shaybani rahimahumallah, who were the main students of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. This made Imam Maturidi rahimahullah the great-great-grand student of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, and thus he taught the people the aqidah of the Salaf via the chain of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. The most accepted and relied upon book of aqidah throughout the ages around the world across the madhahib is written by Imam al-Tahawi rahimahullah, and it is known as al-Aqidah al-Tahawiyyah. This kitab begins with Imam al-Tahawi rahimahullah saying that this is the aqidah of the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah according to the way of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, Imam Abu Yusuf rahimahullah, and Imam Muhammad rahimahullah. And this is what aqidah al-Tahawiyyah is based upon, the aqidah of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. So he made famous the aqidah of the Salaf via the means of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, who was foremost amongst the Salaf. But the ulama mention that Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah actually predates Imam al-Tahawi rahimahullah when it comes to the transmission of the aqidah of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, because he came first and he taught it via this chain of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. So it was on this firm base of the Salaf that Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah authored his famous Kitab al-Tawheed, and in there he laid out the beliefs of the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He also wrote an explanation of Fiqh al-Akbar, which is a book of Aqidah written by Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Apart from the field of Aqidah, Imam al-Maturidi rahimahullah was well versed in all the other sciences of the deen as well. And so he wrote a tafsir of the entire Quran. He wrote books on Usul al-Fiqh as well, the principles of jurisprudence, how the laws of the Sharia are derived. Both Imam al-Ash'ari and Imam al-Maturidi rahimahumallah were from the Salaf, but one was born in the West and the other one was born in the East. Neither one met the other, yet the arguments they used and the groups they fought against were the same. The Aqidah of the Ash'aris and of the Maturidis are so alike that they are often referred to as one and the same. So minute are the differences, which also only occur on a handful of issues that exist on the periphery. But the essence is of both of them is exactly the same, which is only a sign that Allah is the one that guided them both to explain and codify the beliefs of Islam for you and I until the end of the world. These are the Imams of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They are our Imams, and we are proud to attribute ourselves to them. Why should we ever feel shy to say, I am an Ash'ari or I am a Maturidi, when this has been the Aqidah of the Ummah for 1,000 years? You can hardly quote a famous scholar of the past, be it in fiqh, in hadith, in usul, in tariq, in tajweed, or any science of the deen for that matter, but that you will find 99% of the time they will be either an Ash'ari or a Maturidi. Much like you will be extremely hard-pressed to think of a single scholar for 1,000 years after the formulation of the madhahib of fiqh, but that he would be belonging to one of the four madhahib. So we have nothing to be shy of. We are proud to follow Imam al-Ash'ari and Imam al-Maturidi, rahimahumallah. We are proud to follow Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam al-Shafi'i, and Imam Ahmad, rahimahumallahu ta'ala. And those people who find a fault with that, they are the actual ones who are at fault. And we cannot discard the beliefs of the Ummah for 1,000 years to please people that were born the other day who came up with their own interpretation of things. So may Allah grant us the understanding and make us followers of the truth and not people of deviation. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.